pleased to meet you. So I'm not the guy on the program. The guy on the program is my boss. He's the corporate university director. So I have the beard, I have the glasses, not as bold as him for the moment, but I can tell you about what we do with digital learning because I was leading the journey. Maybe first a word about Faurecia. So we are an automotive tech company, the number 7 in the world after acquiring Hella last year. We do a lot of stuff. We do car seats, interiors, exhaust systems, lighting, electronics. So we equip basically one vehicle out of two in the world. We are aiming at doing more than 30 million business very soon. And in terms of learning, what is important, we have 150,000 employees in the world. Okay, in 300 sites all around the globe. So the title of the conference was quite impressive. So I will try to be up to this title. I will talk to you about data. You will be able to evaluate by yourself what we do and the scale of what we do. I will explain the journey, how we build this, and the lessons we learn throughout the different steps of it. Okay, so when we talk about digital learning at Faurecia, we talk about a platform we call the Learning Lab. We connect roughly 100,000 users, so from the CEO to the shop floor workers. We've built that along the years, but we managed to connect pretty much everybody in the company. We do more than 300,000 learning hours a year, official hours. So 328 exactly, and each and every month, roughly, people answer 1 million questions on the platform, and they watch something like 250 videos on the platform also. And our top 10 courses, historically, have been viewed by more than 30,000 people. So. All along the years, we build with our partner a catalog of more than 600 courses. So I have to turn to the screen, but 250 are ours, and the other 350 are the off-the-shelf catalog built by our partner. We have been developing the platform in 23 languages, so for sure, all the catalogs are not the same. We develop the courses according to the country needs and investment. So for sure, we have a big catalog in French, English, Spanish catalog are very big. So is the China one, and then the country progressively invest in localizing the translating the content. And the platform is powered by Corp Academy, now Corp Academy by GoOne. They have been acquired by the Australian unicorn GoOne very recently. They should be around. And we develop all this with them. So they bring us the technology, the platform, the SaaS platform, plus the apps. They bring us the catalog, their off-the-shelf catalog, and the services to produce our own catalog of courses. So each and every year we do some kind of deep dive into the data to see how people are using the technology, the learning technology we provide us. What's interesting is that the usage is quite homogeneous in the various categories of our population, and the usage is quite the same for male and female workers. So I would say the platform has reached a stage where the usage is quite mainstream. It's a good sign because it means we are a standard and we are deeply embedded into the work practice in the company. Maybe it's also a little warning signal because early adopters use the platform quite the same as the average employee, I would say. But the usage is very homogeneous in terms of demographics. It's not the same for geography. For sure, we have far most advanced countries like China and Mexico, for instance. For sure, which are big employment hubs for the automotive industry. So we have a lot of employees in China and Mexico, and they are very active on the platform. All in all, they do something like 40% of the volume, and you can see that their usage is far above average. Things are rebalancing a little bit this year. The US is growing up, but you can see that China and Mexico were heavy power users of the platform. You can see also, we look at the way the different functions use the platform. So you can see that operations are quite heavily users of the platform. So is the HR function. The average usage is roughly 4 hours per year. Operations, they are at almost 8. HR, they are at 9. Direct labor refer to operating workers, the people on the shop floor. We have reached this population in 2019, and you could see that there's still room for growth regarding these deskless employees. It's one of our main development areas for sure. Okay, but we also monitor the way the different functions use the platform. Regarding the topics, the learning topics, no surprise, operational topics come first. So operation account for 40% of the content usage. But what's interesting is that soft skills, leadership, management, diversity and inclusion are also quite strong, and they represent something like 1/4 of the content usage. Compliance is a solid use case for sure. We push the mandatory training through the platform, and you could see that digital is a strong and growing topic with 7% of the usage. So we are on the fundamentals, the operation, but we can see the different topics of interest of our employees, and it's also about soft skills and new ways of working digital. Okay, so that was part of the the picture. If you look at the movie, how we build this, but it's been a journey to embark the user. So we did it by waves. So we started back in 2016, testing the platform, piloting with HR, debugging everything. So I guess we were on IE7 at that time. The platform was not working with IE7. So there was the very hard work at the beginning to craft everything and to put everything in place. Then after, in 2017, we started connecting the managers and the professionals, so roughly 17,000 people. Then we went to all the connected users, so roughly 45,000 people. And in 2019, you can see a jump in the curve because we address the deskless worker internal market to connect roughly the 100,000 people we have in the platform so far. In parallel, we build the catalog, and so has been doing our partner Corp Academy. So when we launched the platform, there were only 5 courses available. So something in between Gravity and The Martian, and now we have 600 courses. We build a service offer internally for the businesses. Something you need to know: the corporate university is in P&L mode. So we propose and sell learning services internally, and we did the same for digital learning. So we sold the digital learning benefits, reach speed cost. We package a service offer, building your courses, ensuring the design, the production, the delivery, the marketing. And we sold it around to the different businesses and functions. And in a way, it became a standard internally. each and every function wanted to have their courses to talk about their fundamentals, their transformation, their processes, their products, and so on. And roughly since 2017, we produce 40 courses internally with Corp Academy. And in addition, they offer us and they offer their other clients 60 off-the-shelf courses. So each and every year, there are 100 courses more on the platform. In parallel, we build the communication pipe. So at the beginning, there were only punctual communication. Then compliance was the first function to put in place communication about the mandatory training. Then we added communication as a service for the business. Then we build a weekly newsletter to match courses with topics of interest for the company. So for instance, pushing a course on AI and speaking about cockpit of the future and how Faurecia innovates into this field. So each and every week we send emails to 50,000 people, and we do it every week along the year. As we were connecting the deskless workers, we build a communication package for the sites ready to be translated. So the QR codes, the posters, the flyers, the videos to be displayed on the plant screens. For sure, with the app in 2020 came the notifications. And in 2021, we put in place the automatic assignment rules in the LMS. So what's striking at Faurecia, we started with the LXP, with the Learning Lab, and the LMS came far later, which was both a blessing and a curse, because we could focus on the user experience. But we put in place the success factor full suite, including the LMS. And since last year, we can profile the people according to HR data and push to them relevant digital training. So we do multi-channel communication and assignment. And very recently, we activated the Teams app, Corp Academy Teams app, for Teams to be also an entry door onto the platform. As since COVID crisis, everybody is on Teams for sure for their daily work. For sure, we build the infrastructure all along the way. So we started with a manual import of Excel files, a standard login and password to be changed at first connection. First game changer was SSO and auto-provisioning, for sure. Then came the app for people to have a mirror experience both on their laptop and on their smartphones. We put in place a process in 2020 for the accounting of learning hours. That was really important because it's through this process, each and every HR site manager can record the time their employees spend on the platform. So that's part of the official HR reporting, and that's consolidating at the group level for the reference document. We are currently still strengthening the infrastructure. So we want to put more data in the SSO. For the deskless workers, we want to automatize the provisioning via flat file based on SuccessFactor. And we are looking also at what Microsoft is proposing for Viva Learning to embed digital learning into the workflow. And you could see the acceleration of the learning volumes. If you look at the number of questions answered on the platform by slices of 10 million. So it took us 2 years to reach our first million, then another year to reach 3 million. And now, basically, we do 10 million of questions in less than one year. We will cross the 40 million questions, I guess, next month. So what did we learn along the way? It's always to focus on the next step, on the next wave. So what should be the next wave of users? So we connected roughly all the employees at Faurecia. Now we are connecting the employees at Ella, the company we acquired. And we are thinking, we are also, it's a brand new project, proposing to our suppliers to also connect to a mirror platform, thinking a bit in terms of extended company. So it's part of the purchasing roadmap to have deep relationships with the community of suppliers. And that's what we are proposing through through the platform. What also is key is to think of the next wave of topics. So we match, we stick to the company news, trying to anticipate them. So hybrid work is a big topic following COVID crisis. We do content about hybrid work, for sure, Ella integration. We try to capture all the topics. We work with group communication to build a continuum between communication, learning, information, and training. We also produce or share content to the outside market via Corp Academy. We co-build content with Numa about agility. Our course on CO2 neutrality was proposed to the other companies via Corp Academy catalog. For sure, we also focus on the next wave of content formats. So we try to test a lot of things and then to industrialize. So we've launched micro-learning, interactive articles, podcasts, TED Talks like with experts. And now we are focusing on simulations, building a full catalog of simulations, putting people in a context and analyzing their decision. We look at, for sure, the next wave of functionalities on the platform. We have in our roadmap and on Corp Academy roadmap some kind of revision mode with an algorithm pushing you the topics you don't master that much. We want to work on multi-level content structuration. For sure, with 600 courses, you need to provide guidance for people to find their ways. So it's about multi-level structuration, and it's also about AI-powered search to make sure you've been pushed the right content for you. And for sure, we also look at the next wave of integrations. What can we do with our social network? And for sure, what can we do with the Microsoft environment, starting with Viva, for sure. But at the same time, we need to keep strong on our core businesses, because if you focus only on experimentation and new things, then you lose your fundamentals and it can be pretty dangerous. So we have some kind of constant discipline to make sure we acquire new clients internally, we develop new content, we need to keep the rhythm of 40, 50 courses a year. Trying as much as possible to level the production, which is always a challenge. We have strong use cases and we need to reinforce them, compliance, operations. We did a lot of things last year with the digital transformation team about the digital service factory and so on. So finding always new courses and new topics. And we built standards along the way regarding the kind of courses we want to produce, the quality standards with the suppliers, the graphics standards, etc., to make sure we deliver on time, on budget, and on quality. So we are an industrial company, we manage it an industrial way, and the people in operations help us craft all this. And for sure, we don't just produce, we show results to the clients, so we do reporting, we do marketing, we make sure they have an impact for the money they put on the project. So it's important to be on the next wave, but really to focus on the core business and to work on these two feet for sure. What's important also, at least in the way we work, is to think B2B2C. We have clients, we have users, so we should forget neither of them. The client, the function, the business, because they are the one buying the platform and the content, and the content is theirs. So we need constantly to remind them of the benefit of the platform, to prove our capacity to cover their needs with a new innovation and mastering the full value chain. When we see a need, we help them put it in the right format, And we accompany them from the design to the ROI monitoring. And for sure also, we focus on the UX, the experience of users. And it's key to ensure that through the platform, they can learn about the company transformation, the new businesses, the new products, the new ways of working. They can master the fundamentals of their job. And they can also take care of their self-development and employability. The good thing is the platform is the same for everybody. Everybody has access to the same catalog of content. And in a lot of countries, the Learning Lab is perceived as a benefit for employees because they can learn on whatever topics, whenever they want, and on any device, including their personal device. And for sure, last but not the least, all this is about building an ecosystem. So for sure, an ecosystem of prescribers. So we have a strong sponsorship from the group HRIVP, Jean-Pierre Souninac, who is constantly advocating monitoring the platform. He's receiving each and every month monthly reporting to see how the countries are behaving in terms of usage and volume. And he really backed us all along the way. The fun thing is, at the end of each and every course, there's a picture of him giving you a feedback, should you have failed or succeeded in doing the course. So he's really heavily involved in the success of the platform. We rely on the HR function to do the deployment of the platform through the countries, through the sites. So each and every country is monitoring the local usage of the platform. Each and every HR site is monitoring the performance of their plant or of R&D centers. And they are really our sales network to make sure the platform is used. We are also working with the power users of the platform, so the top 100, to do beta testing, to get their feedback on the new things we want to promote, new content, new functionalities. It's a relationship that is important for us to test in advance things we can leverage. So for sure, part of your ecosystems are your clients, so we regularly go to them. So it's part of our routine to have reporting about the impact, the efficiency of their content, but we regularly go to them to showcase the new things we can do with them on the platform and to see if they have new topic to address. Something also we build is a content development ecosystem. So for sure it's about such a platform is about technology service but also content. So we partner more and more with group communication. There's some kind of continuum between communication and learning. Hot news, cool news, learning. So we have a project in common, including this platform. What we are currently working on is developing a network of subject matter experts that can contribute internally on advanced topics like, the metaverse, for instance. What does it mean for an automotive company? Is it about putting the metaverse in the automotive or maybe putting the automotive in the metaverse and what does it mean? So we are trying at the moment to identify internal contributors and we are also looking for external contributors like economic professors to give analysis about the evolution of the business context, things like that. So enriching the ecosystem of content developers with the equivalent of columnists in a newspaper, for instance. We want to have a new thread of content. So it's always about enriching the ecosystem. For sure, relationship with IT is quite key. So we know each and every expert by their name, be it for the HR data, all the Microsoft environment, the SSO expert, for sure the cybersecurity team, etc. And that's a network you need to master whenever you want to push a platform in a corporate environment. And for sure, all this was developed thanks to a powerful project team. So not that big, hein, two or three people at the corporate university and working with Corp Academy, Customer Success Management, and we build this all together. Okay. So that's it for the talking.
All right, thank you so much. So we have time for questions. So, and here.
Hello, thank you very much for your sharing. I've got two questions. The first one is in relationship with the localization of your content. I mean, in terms of translation, how do you manage that? And the second one is in a relationship with how do you evaluate the performance of your employees after the trainings? Do you manage it, or is it a HR responsibility? Thank you very much.
The first question is far easier than the second one, for sure. So translation. The Corporate Academy catalog, they come with various languages, and we add some more. So what did we do? We put in place some kind of translation factory. We have an Indian colleague managing this in Pune, and the platform comes with an automatic translation functionality. And then we adjust according to country needs. So we do dubbing, for sure the platform is video-based, we do subtitles according to time frame, budget, expectations. But it's a constant production workflow starting with the operational content. Regarding the impact on the upskilling, I would say that operations are the more advanced into this. They really embedded learning and digital learning into the work standards, and we build specific curriculum function by function. And the learning effort is also included and correlated with the plant ranking system. They rank the plants according to their performance, and they could see a correlation between the learning effort and the plant and the plant efficiency. So operation, which is doing roughly half of the learning hours on the platform, are quite advanced into this, monitoring the ROI and embedding learning into the work routines.
Right, thank you. Other questions?
Yes, hello. Thank you very much for the presentation. So we know that companies as big as Faurecia normally have people and employees around the world. Do you have a strategy to keep the employees engaged? Because we know that people don't have time for learning and everything. So beside the communication, do you have any other strategy to keep the learning as top priority for them as well?
Yeah, but I would say it's a mix of a push and pull strategy. And it's a mix of a marketed approach and a mandatory training approach. But first, we bet on the user experience. The platform is quite aligned with web standards, and it's a learning experience platform, an LXP, not an LMS, learning management system. The learning management is there. It came relatively late, and it's the administrative backbone, but all the learning happened in an environment which is quite modern, quite aligned with web standards. As I told you, we make a big effort to regularly push and market content, attract people interest. So it's about communicating on the content, but making the effort to relate the content to the news of the company. So as soon as we acquired Ella, we started working on content to explain what Ella was doing. And day one was in March, and as of day one, there was a full content package to explain how the integration would work and what were the specificities of each and every company. Today, for instance, is Forvia Day, so it's the new celebration of the new company. And we send a specific communication this morning. There are surprises on the platform, like a new look and feel. You have one extra chance to validate the content, etc. So we try also to regularly build animation and make sure people have fun on the platform, though it is a corporate learning platform, but at least to make it as fun as possible. Then also, on the other side, we do the hardcore learning job. So we build curriculum for the people. We match them with specific training according to their HR profile. And this is done through the HRIS system and the LMS. But once again, we try to balance both the push and pull, the marketed approach and the push approach.
Thank you again for your presentation. I have two questions. So it's a corporate solution with a corporate content that you provide with all the translations. So countries are paying for it? That's my first question.
Yep.
And the second question would be regarding the deskless workers. How did you reach the plant?
Okay, so first question was about the business model, internal business model. Yes, so we recharge the licenses to the businesses. So it's a global yearly fee, semester fee, according to the number of employees into the platform. And then we charge the clients for the projects. So each and every time they want to develop a new course, there's a price associated to the full package, the design, the production, the delivery. There's a catalog of services, but we charge the clients, not the users. The users, licenses, they are taken care of by the business group.
Okay, so you are an academy factory.
Yeah. We are an internal service provider, but we manage a P&L. That's the way the corporate university was designed. And we do it for digital learning as we do it for classroom learning. That's our global business model. Second question was about connecting deskless workers. But there are various aspects to it. There's a techno component. So how do you authenticate them? So we don't have a federated authentication for deskless workers, so they authenticate themselves directly into the app. So they have a login and a password. I will not explain, but they identify with their employee number and a specific password that each and everyone can remind. So that's the technical thing. How do we authenticate them? Then how do you boost usage? We rely on the HR manager of the plant, of the site, to build training plans for them. So we do centralized push through the country that are cascaded down to the HR sites. But the HR sites, the sites are quite autonomous in building their learning plans, their training plans for the workers.
And therefore, you provide them mobiles. How do they access?
Alors, they access in each and every possible way. The plants put in place hardware for them to access the platform. So they are either learning booths, tactile screens, learning rooms with computers. But they have also the opportunity to download the apps should they want it. It's not mandatory because it's an option we offer to them, and generally they do it quite appealing.
F-
Thank you very much for the presentation. Just one question. You mentioned a KPI on a question asked at the beginning, like 40 million was your KPI. Can you re-explain what is the question?
Yeah. We have some kind of a template for the courses. It's based on video lessons plus questions. So one of the KPI with monitor is the number of questions answered each and every month. And roughly, we do 1 million questions each month. So that's fine. Last 2 months, we were doing 1.2 million questions answered throughout the company, actually.
Thank you.
We may get 1 million in this session, so here's the next one.
Thank you. Thanks for your presentation. My question is, do you have a predefined competency model that you work against? And if yes, how do you match that competency model with the trainings you have on the platform?
Yep. There are various frameworks in the company. So DHR, they own a leadership competency model. So we develop courses to cover and match all these leadership competencies. So these are soft skills, not hard skills. And then, for instance, the lean manufacturing is a big thing at Faurecia. You've got what we call the Faurecia Excellence System with something like four big categories and 60 standards from pull flow, attack time, this kind of technical stuff. So we develop courses on all these fundamentals, actually. So for sure, we try to spot the structuring framework into the organization and to develop content accordingly. And I would say yes, two big frameworks are soft skills, leadership competency owned by HR and lean manufacturing, FES owned by the operations.
Thank you.
Hello, thank you for the presentation. In the list of topics you mentioned, I didn't see quality. I think quality is one of the fundamentals of Faurecia. Is it embedded in somewhere, or you have some separate system to manage quality topic?
Yes, all the training about quality, they are part largely of the Faurecia Excellence System. So it's embedded into the operation portfolio and for the story, we've just developed a series of 10 courses about quality in engineering. So that's the operation family, I would say, but quality, we produce a lot of content for sure.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Time for maybe one more if we have it. I think we've had so many questions. I think we've covered it. So let's thank Guillaume again for a wonderful presentation.
Thank you.